Luke's Chapel. Thank you for being here today and for tuning in. We pray for the repose of the souls of those who have died in the hope of the resurrection. Rhonda Jane, Joanne Kendall, Joanne Bowen, Brandon Ellie, and Glenn McCoy.
Of resurrection, earth now. Welcome to St. Luke's Chapel. Those who are in chapel with us are certainly welcome to receive the sacrament of Holy Communion. Those listening from afar, get a cracker or some bread and a glass of wine or some juice and share in the sacraments at the time we do. God's love is eternal. God's love is universal, and He's everywhere with us. Let us pray. God, we come to you in this hour of worship to give thanks for all that you have given us as we seek forgiveness for any wrongdoing that we may have done. We ask that you guide us, guard us, and protect us with your might as we offer ourselves to your service. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you all for being here on a nice summer day. I remind you it is April, okay, so don't be disappointed if we have to wear our winter woolies again. Several people on the prayer list who have died this week. One was Joanne Kendall, who was in North Carolina, but she was very involved in St. Luke's from a distance, and she sent us the new crock pots that are downstairs for our dinners, and she was diagnosed with cancer on March 31st and died last Tuesday. So our prayers are certainly with her and her family. The last Saturday of the month, we still have the birthday dinner after church. The other dinners have stopped till fall. We'll try to do that again, I think, next winter, because that went over quite well. We enjoyed that. We have ordered the new heater air conditioner units for downstairs. They should be installed in June, and we're going with a firm from that was very reasonable from Manfour Falls, and so they were very good people, family-owned business. So we next winter you won't have to be so cold, okay? So I think that's wonderful that we're doing that. Sandy is back from North Carolina. Do you have anything to confess, Sandy?
That's the whole group of United.
Okay. I was thinking of Jesus' words, let those without sin cast the first stone. So were there any stones cast? So there was some sins there then. Okay, very good. Wouldn't want you to go and not have fun.
No.
Trudy, you had something you wanted to say. Who's that? Oh, for Ellie. What was her last name? Oh, Brandon Ellie. Yeah, we have him on the prayer list. Yeah. Any other announcements, concerns? So, we're glad to have Rita back from her Southern Ventures. And glad to see so many people. It's nice to have so many here. Easter was wonderful. We had a great Easter service and a Good Friday service. So, that went well. Today's gospel introduces us to Thomas, who helped to coin the phrase Doubting Thomas, because he lived so much in the material world that he had to see Jesus for himself and prove to himself without any doubt that it was Jesus. And I think in our faith journey, we all sometimes have doubts within our faith. And I think there's nothing wrong with that, because I think it challenges our faith. I think it's an example for us to, and why Thomas was there, I think it's an example for us to challenge our faith with doubt. Because it'll be through that doubt that our faith will be proven to us. This morning's letter I sent out, I talked about the words from the cross, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And in Jesus's intuitive wisdom, he knew that what was happening to him would be good for humanity and would prove that the body is temporal, but the spirit is eternal. And it's up to us to have to decide whether to accept that or reject that. And I think a lot of that, we just have to decide how we want the Bible to be for us. Do we want it to be a literal interpretation? Or do we want it to be a gift of love that is personally pertinent to each of us? I think as we read the Bible, there's probably as many interpretations in the Bible as there are people. And I think that we have to find in biblical readings what is comfortable for our journey. And I think we have to determine that Jesus often spoke to us in Proverbs. He often spoke to us with example. He often spoke to us in a way that would connect our spiritual life with our everyday life. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. He knew that his death was going to change the world. And it has for over 2,000 years. I referred to the incident in Tennessee last week where two black senators were dismissed from Congress, later reinstated. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And I think the people that did that thought it was an open and shut case. They're gone. Well, got rid of them. But what they did was ignite a fire among the people because they saw the goodness in what these young men were doing. There's a lot of innuendos. It was two black men, two young black men, accused of having tantrums because things weren't going their way, because they were outside protesting gun issues that were killing our children in schools. I don't consider that a tantrum. But one white woman was not taken out, even though she was with them. And I think we have to stop and think of the involvement of our own humanity. What might have been prejudice? What might have been control? What might have been intent? And as Jesus says from the cross, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. How many times in my own life should I have heard those words and didn't? Father, forgive Phil, because he really doesn't know what he's doing. And I think that we all have been in that position. Father, forgive us, for we know not what we do. He had the intuitive wisdom to know what was to come, but the others, the accusers, did not. And we have to look into our faith and decide what in our faith should we accept and where is it all right to doubt. I can remember in my faith journey early on that even if I had a thought that went against the teachings of the church, I thought, well, I'm going to hell, no doubt about that, because I thought that. But I've come to learn through my faith of spiritual wisdom, spiritual knowledge, things that God wants for us. When Jesus appeared to his disciples, it's repeated three times in today's reading. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. And that's what he wanted for us. It's through the love of God that he discovered. He wanted us to have peace. Peace be with us. He could have very easily said, look what you people just did. Aren't you ashamed of yourselves? He didn't. Peace be with you. And even in that excruciating death, he was able to exemplify kindness He was able to exemplify the Spirit of God. When the two thieves, one on the right and one on the left, ridiculed him. If you're the Savior, save us, save yourself. When you get to heaven, the heaven that you call heaven, pray for us there. And he didn't say, well, I'm going to heaven, you're not. He said, before this day is over, we shall be together in paradise. And yet today, in 2023, we have Christians who are very apt to say, well, I'm going to heaven, but you're not. Because you believe differently than I believe. Is that what God wants for us? God wants us all to be with those that we have loved. And I don't know about you, but can't you sense the people you love around you at certain times in family gatherings? Don't you see signs of people that have cherished you in life? Doesn't Jesus appear to you 2,000 years later in the presence of others? The face of Jesus, there's been artist renditions throughout history of the face of Jesus. But I see the face of Jesus in many different people. In many different ways. I see the face of Jesus in my doctor. She's Jewish. And probably one of the saviors of my life. I see the face of Jesus in family, in friends. Because the blood of Jesus was given for us, and that comes into our being and runs through our veins. I've seen the faces that I wish would see Jesus. But I didn't tell them that, because they have to come to know that. And I repeat things that I have said before, but nothing provokes me more than having someone come up to me, especially if I'm wearing my collar. Phil, have you found Jesus? Have you taken Jesus into your heart? So I get so frustrated with that, I just say, well, that's none of your business. That's between me and Jesus. That's between me and the God of my understanding, the God that I know loves me. And I hope that you have found the face of Jesus. Jesus came to us as the Son of God because humanity needed an example to follow. And don't we all follow examples? And sometimes really good examples. And sometimes not such good examples. Sometimes I know that Jesus has said again and again, Father, forgive Phil, he doesn't know what he's doing. And a few people haven't heard that. Listen for it. Listen for it. And you'll turn around a situation that will be positive. Will come to light as a good thing. Don't doubt your faith. Your faith is as much a gift as the gift of love. Your faith is personal to you. We come together in a camaraderie, in a common bond of love, and an understanding of the God of our understanding. But for every person here, you have a different journey in faith. Don't try to change another person from their journey to yours, because they have to experience their journey to discover their faith. So let's all go out and listen for the words that Jesus tells us. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And forgiveness is like love. You have to forgive yourself before you can forgive others. You have to love yourself before you can love others. I think of the years I wasted not loving myself because I believed what dysfunctional people had told me. And I wish I could go back in a way to those times. Can't go back. The body's too far gone. But I can go back in my mind and I can cherish what life has offered me. So let us all go forth in peace to love and to serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let us stand and share together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us remember the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." The alms basin is in the back for those who would like to leave a donation for our church.
Our offertory is number 192, will be verses 1 and 2.
Thank you.
God, we come before your altar this day asking for forgiveness for any sins or offenses that we have done against you, our God, against your creation, against our neighbors or against ourselves. We ask forgiveness for these our sins. We give thanks for all that you have given us, for our family and our friends, for our church and our parish family, for our community, the state, the nation, and the world in which we live. Help us to preserve your creation for the generations yet to come, that they too may be partakers of your kingdom here on earth as in heaven. We pray for all people who cannot be with us, especially for the sick and the suffering, and for all people for whom our prayers are now desired. God, we ask you to be with the people of the Ukraine, that their faith will lead them to victory to maintain their democracy. We pray for our country with the political strife that we go through, the natural disasters of storms and fires and earthquakes. Keep us ever mindful that your love will prevail for us. And we trust your faith that you will touch all of us with your healing power. We pray this day for all those who have died in the hope of the resurrection. We pray especially for Joanne Kendall, Rhonda Jane, Joanne Bowen, Glenn McCoy, Brandon Ely. We trust through faith that you have opened your arms in love and mercy and received them into your heavenly kingdom. Be with their families and friends as they mourn their loss, that their empty hearts may be filled with the consolation of your love and the joyful memories they have shared throughout the years. And now together let us confess our sins unto Almighty God. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in our thoughts, in our words, and in our deeds. By what we have done and by what we have left undone, we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We seek forgiveness for these our sins, and are heartily sorry for these our wrongdoings. Have mercy on us and forgive us our sins, so that we may return to your path and walk in your ways all our days. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be always with you. In chapel, let us nod peace to one another. At home, embrace those you love with your peace. was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Take and eat this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup of wine. When he had given thanks, he shared it among his friends. And he said, "Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as oft as you shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, Lord, we present ourselves, our souls and bodies, in reasonable hope to life everlasting, trusting through our faith and our love of you that you shall always be with us, that we can never be alone. Strengthen us with your good spirit that we may come to know your love for us, following the example that you have given us through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us all to pray. Gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you. Feed on them in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Amen. Those who would like to receive the sacraments, if you would come forward.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God, we give you thanks that you have fed us with the spiritual food of the blessed body and blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Send us out into the world, giving us the things to do that are necessary for your creation. As we offer ourselves to him who died and rose again, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. O God, keep us ever mindful of your love for us. Be with our servicemen and women, harbor them in safety. Be with the people of the Ukraine, restore their faith in democracy. Be with our people in our United States, that we may come together in a bond of love that you created for us. And keep us ever mindful of our own gifts, that we will continue to pursue our gifts and share them in your creation. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, may he be with us this day and remain with us always. Amen. Amen. Amen.
How close are you?